Then next topic is nothing but algorithm for asynchronous checkpointing recovery. I have previously told that we are having a two types of algorithm. Both algorithms are very important for the exam purpose. Curve or network algorithm. In this algorithm, we are having it two parts, checkpointing algorithm and then recovery algorithm. We are having separate algorithms for checkpointing and then recovery. In checkpointing algorithm, again the checkpoints are divided into two. For this algorithm purpose only, they are again dividing the checkpoint into permanent checkpoint and then tentative checkpoint. Permanent checkpoint is nothing but a local checkpoint that is a part of the consistent global state. And then tentative checkpoint is nothing but it is a temporary permanent checkpoint. It is a temporary checkpoint. It becomes permanent checkpoint when the algorithm terminates successfully. That means every end of the transaction, the tentative checkpoint will be converted into permanent checkpoint. That is the meaning of the terminate successfully. So at first you will have a tentative checkpoint. The tentative checkpoint will be converted into a permanent checkpoint. Next we are having a two phases in checkpointing algorithm. First one is that the initiating process takes place that all the process requests the tentative checkpoint and all the process should possess the tentative checkpoint. And then all process, second phase is nothing but all process will receive the final decision from the initiating process. For example, if we are having a process P0, that is the initiating process, it will possess the checkpoints to the P1 up to Pn. That is the meaning of this. So the P0 is nothing but the initiating process. The P0 will have the authority to possess the tentative checkpoints to all other process P1 to Pn. We are having a two phases. First, we have completed the checkpointing algorithm. Second, we have the two algorithms. In checkpointing recovery algorithm, we are having a permanent and tentative. The tentative checkpoints will be converted into permanent. In the checkpoint, we are having two phases. The first initiating process requests all the process to take the tentative checkpoint, and then it will receive the final from the initiating process. Second one is the recovery algorithm. Second part is recovery algorithm. We reach for the system state to a consistent state after recovery. Here also we are having two phases. Here the initiating process send a message to all other process and ask the preferences. It will ask the preferences for restarting to the previous checkpoints. We may have a n number of checkpoints. We may have a n number of checkpoints, and then in which checkpoint the process should be continued, that preference will be asked by the initiating process, that is the P0, to all other process up to Pn. Okay? And all other process act accordingly after receiving a final decision from the initiating process. So the P0, if the P0 is initiating process, it will say if the authority has authority to give it to ask preference that we have to start from the checkpoints. So each process will have the separate checkpoints. Here we are having an example diagram that will explain the area. For example, we are having X and Y two processes. We are having the checkpoints X1, X2. Here we are having checkpoints Y1 and Y2. Each process may have a n number of checkpoints. Here the failure occurs. For example, here the part the failure occurs means we may go from a X1 or X2 in the process X, or we may go to Y2 or Y1 in the process Y. It depends on the failure, we may go to the any checkpoints. That is the advantage of this algorithm. This algorithm, curve coordinated checkpointing algorithm, we have a n number of checkpoints those checkpoints will be continued back based on the application. We may go from X2 to X1, or we may go from Y2 or Y1. So this algorithm represents, we have two parts, that is between the checkpointing and recovery. In both we are having a two phases. In all the phases, the initiating process is taking up the chart. Then we are having n number of checkpoints in this algorithm. Next we are going to see about the long regulation algorithm for asynchronous checkpointing algorithm. In this algorithm, we are having a storage, that is volatile log and then spring log. We are having a two types of storage. Volatile log is nothing but that. It is a short time to access, and then it is a but lost if the processor crashed. Okay, and then it will be moved to stable storage periodically. Okay? And then stable storage takes longer time to access, remained even the system rest. That is nothing but from the name itself, you can understand that volatile log will be have the storage for a shorter time, and it can be accessed easily. But if the processor crashes, the storage will be lost. All the storage will be at first in the volatile log, then it will be converted to the stable log. Stable log takes a longer time to access, but it will be remained even the system crash occurs. Okay, and then we are having a notations for receiving and sending in this algorithm. RCVD J2I checkpoint of I indicates that the number of messages received by PI from PJ. This indicates the receiving authority, and this indicates the sending authority. The PJ is sending something to the PI. The PA is a receiver, and then PJ is a sender from the beginning of the computation to the checkpoints. For example, we are having a n number of messages starting from 0 to, for example, 10 means our checkpoint is 7 in the sense we will have a messages 0 to 7 here. Like that, it will have a n number of messages received by PI from PJ. PI is a sender, and then PJ is a receiver. Here, PI is a sender, and then PJ is a receiver. Next, we are having a notation for the sending. Here, send of I to J, checkpoint of I. Indicates the number of messages sent by PI to PJ from the beginning of computation to the checkpoints. Here it indicates PI is a sender and then PJ is a receiver. In the previous, it indicates PI is a receiver and then PJ is a sender. Okay, here PI acts as a sender, here PJ acts as a receiver. Here PJ acts as a sender, PA acts as a receiver. So we have to represent the sending and the receiving based on the notations only. Here we are having a detailed algorithmic explanation for the long regulation. Here we are having two types of steps. First one is step A, and then second one is step B. In step A, the processor PI is recovering after a failure, then the checkpoint will be latest event logged. In this algorithm, there may be only one checkpoint. The checkpoint will be last event which should be present in the log. We are having a volatile log, and then we are having stable log. Whatever may be the log, the latest event present in the volatile and stable log will be stored as a checkpoint. If PI is not in the failure mode, else checkpoint equal to latest event that took place in PI. In PI, we may have a number of events up to from E0 to EN. So the checkpoint will be in the those one of the events from E0 to EN. This is the first step. Based on the PI is recovering after failure, we are having a two types. First one is the checkpoint or the lost latest event. Second one checkpoint is nothing but a last event took place in the today. Here the event will be taken from the log. Here the event will be taken from the process. Okay. And the next one is the step 2. Step 2 is nothing but step B. Here we are having a grouping because we have to find out the neighboring processes and we have to send the messages from one person to another. For that purpose, we need a grouping function for K1 to Kn. For each process Pj, we have to compute this. Compute, send off I, j and checkpoint. And then send a rollback message along with the send to the Pj. For example, if at first Pi will be, Pi will be 0 and then Pj will be 1. And then next Pi will be 1, Pj will be 2. And then next Pi will be 2 and then Pj will be 3. It goes like that. So the I and the N will be increased and it will goes up to here N minus 1 and then here N. Okay. So depends on the number of processes. This loop will be repeated. It will compute the same message and then it will compute the rollback message. Next thing is that for every rollback message, it will save. It has to receive the checkpoint also. If received of I, j, checkpoint greater than C. For example, here we are having a process. Yes, my checkpoint is here, but I received the process here in the sense I can go to the checkpoint. But in you take the example Y. My checkpoint is here. I received the message here means I can't go with the checkpoint. That is the if received of I, j, checkpoint greater than C means you can go with the process. So this one will be a correct and this checkpoint can't be accessed. They are telling that thing in a if condition. And then after that we have to find the latest that is logged. That will be on the checkpoint. Okay. Here we will see with the example. In this example, x and y, we are having a ex0, x1 and x2 number of events, ey0, y1, y2 up to n number of events. But here we are having a only x1 and then we will have y1. Only two checkpoints are here. If the process crashed the screen, it will go to either y1 or it will go to either x1. In this algorithm, it will take only one checkpoint. But if we take the code work algorithm, actually we have seen the previous algorithm, it will take the n number of checkpoints. But in wrong regulation algorithm, it will take only one checkpoint. The difference between the two algorithms is something like it will have a n number of checkpoint and this algorithm will have a single checkpoint. So this diagram represents the strong regression algorithm. It will have only one checkpoint. That checkpoint will have the latest event log or latest event in the process y or x. Okay. I think you all of you can understand the algorithms well. We will have a look on what are the topics we have seen today. I have told about the unit 1, 2, 3, what is the built on unit 1, 2, 3, and then unit 4 algebra. I have finished the recovery, and then in recovery, we have a checkpointing and rollback recovery, interaction, issues in failure recovery, types of failure messages, techniques, and then algorithms. Okay? In the introduction, we have been seen about the what is mean by checkpoint and then rollback. And then in how to model the checkpoint, CFI comma A and then CFI comma 0. And then we have seen the types of messages, interactive, instances, lost, delayed, orphan, duplicate. And then here basic type of checkpoint is autonomous and then closed. Based on the application, the checkpoint may vary. And then we have seen about the domino effect. The dependencies may code some process that did not fail to detect and it is called dynamic mapping. To avoid the dynamic mapping, we are having three techniques. First one is the coordinating checkpointing. In coordinated checkpoint, we are having a blocking and then non-blocking. In blocking, the process will get blocked and in the checkpointing, non-blocking, it will not get blocked. And then we have seen checkpointing the resistance. And then how to avoid checkpointing resistance? We have to use the FIFO algorithm. We have seen the communicated induced checkpoint log based. And then we have seen the two algorithms, code-code coordinated checkpointing and then wrong validation checkpointing. I hope that all of you can understand whatever the topics we have seen today. In this topic, the most important thing is you have to learn about the algorithms, the both algorithms, two algorithms, one validation algorithm. These two algorithms are most important in the code unit. Since it comes under the question of the code unit, you should create the list of algorithms. You can refer this video and then I can send another PDF also. Based on the PDF, you take your MCQs and do it. Thank you all.